الحمد لله، الحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى من استنى بسنته واقتفى أثره إلى يوم الدين. أيها الأحبة في الله، أفضل الذكر لا إله إلا الله، وأفضل الدعاء الحمد لله، وأفضل العمل اتباع سنة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. We thank and praise Allah سبحانه وتعالى, the one and the only one. And we send peace and blessings upon his messenger, Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, and those who followed him from his companions, and the followers of the companions, all the way until it reached us. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we remind each other that the best of all remembrance is to say La ilaha illallah. And the best of gratitude and shukr is to say Alhamdulillah. And the best of action that you can do in this life that you will be rewarded for is to follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Brothers and sisters, our khutbah is about death. And it's really summarized in three questions. Pay attention to those questions and know that if you answered them, you will be from the people of Jannah, inshallah. Easy questions, very easy questions. All of you knows the answers. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you your entire life. Whatever years you live, just to answer these questions. The questions are known to us, and the answers are known to us. Sadly, the majority fail. Let's take a look at hadith Jabir ibn al-Bara ibn Azib radiyallahu anhu. Bara ibn Azib radiyallahu anhu is telling us a hadith that is a result of a janazah. He said one of the Ansar died, so we attended his janazah and we followed the janazah to the graveyard for burial. So we reached the grave and the lahd was not ready yet. The lahd is not the grave itself. Inside the grave, there will be an area that will be dug a little bit in depth in the grave where you put the deceased in it. That's called lahd. It wasn't ready yet. This is the sunnah. So basically, we had to sit and wait. So Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sat at the edge of the grave. And he has short stick or something small, a twig in his hand. And he start poking the ground with it. Usually a person does that when they are busy thinking about something, worried about something. Now we know this is an event of witnessing death, looking at a grave, which is the beginning of the hereafter. And this grave is a visit. That means you're not going to be there forever. Unfortunately, a lot of people think death is the end of it. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah At-Takathur, أَلْهَاكُمُ التَّكَاثُرُ حَتَّى زُرْتُمْ الْمَقَابِرُ. You got busy in this world until you visited the grave. Have you ever visited someone and stayed there forever? The visit has to end. Going to the grave has to end. What's the end? Day of judgment. So it's the beginning. So he was digging, and the Sahaba was so concerned all the time. When they are with the Prophet ﷺ, they pay attention with anything and everything he does and says. They watch everything. So he said, كَأَنَّ عَلَى رُؤُوسِنَا الطَّيْرِ. We were sitting there so silent and so quiet, motionless, as if birds standing on our heads. And you know when birds do that? When they think that you are a trunk of a tree, not a living person. Yani you were dead, literally. That's how prepared to see and hear from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So he said sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he lifted his head and told the companions radiallahu anhum that this deceased person will be hearing the footsteps of us when we leave. Yani his soul will come back to him. And then he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, يَأْتِيهِ مَلَكَان. Two angels would come to him. فَيُجْلِسَانِ. They will seat him. Yani, not lying anymore. He would sit just like you're sitting. How? This is a different life, different world, different rules. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that. فَيُجْلِسَانِ فَيَقُولَانِ لَهُ. They ask him three questions. مَنْ رَبُّكَ. Who's your Lord? مَا دِينُكَ. What's your religion? What do you believe in? مَا تَقُولُ فِي هَذَا الرَّجُلِ الَّذِي بُعِثَ فِيكُمْ. What do you say about that man who was sent to you? In a different narration, مَنْ نَبِيُّكَ. Who's your prophet? Based on how you lived your life, based on what you did in your life, the answers would come. I want you to reflect that when you are in the grave, the word grave is scary by itself. Think and picture where you will be and how when you're locked up and how when all the dirt on top of you, how when your family and no one but you alone, and how when you wake up and you take a look at two angels, where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us that the wing of angel Jibreel alayhi salam covered the entire sky. Imagine yourself nowadays, now, if you hear sound in your house, you don't know where it's coming from, or you see a shadow or something, you freak out, and you move, and you sell, and you call every sheikh, and you can't sleep anymore just because of that. Imagine when you are in the grave, and when you are alone, and when you see the angels not there. How much information are you going to remember? If someone screams in your face, you forget your name. And you're going to be there. And some people who are lacking knowledge, so arrogant, so ignorant, you know what they do? They sit on the grave after they bury the person, and then they would say, if the angel comes to you and asks you who is your Lord, tell him Allah. If he asks you who's your prophet, tell him Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If they ask you, how did you know? Tell them I read the Quran. Good job. And they go home, feels good. Now this person is going to get 100 in the exam because we cheated him, because we gave him the answer. You know, in dunya, you're a loser if you cheat and if someone catches you. And I guess you got away with it with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He didn't see that. He created us so you live with your desires. You don't do anything good. And at the time of the test, someone will come and cheat you and you end up in Jannah. How can someone in the right mind think this way? But believe it or not, you know it and I know it, people do exist, and a lot, they do that. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us this question will be given. Based on your answers, if you answer it correctly, your grave will be furnished from heaven. You will be dressed from heaven. You will have a look and you see your spot in heaven. And your grave will be so spacious as far as your eyes see. A lot of people get scared of death and the grave. And you're right. But if you're doing good and you live your life good, why would you be scared when this is the result? But if you live in a different world and not believe in all of that, and then come and say like what people said in here, illa hayatuna dunya namutu wa nahya. This is life, we live and we die, and then nothing after that. Then you will be from those people when they will be asked those questions, who would say, man rabbuk, who's your Lord? No answer. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, for those people, an angel will be there who is blind and deaf with a mallet or a stick in his hand. If he hits a person, rather if he hits a mountain, the mountain will be crushed to sand. And he will hit that person with it, the one who doesn't know the answers. He said he would scream from pain if anything on earth, human or animals, heard it, will immediately die. You know how the Day of Judgment starts? When Angel Israfil blows in the trumpet and everyone dies from the sound of it? Well, this is similar. The scream of that person does that. Now, brothers and sisters, three questions, they're so easy. You know it and I know it. But it comes in a different place and in a different time and in a situation that is so hard and so scary. What's the first question? Man Rabbuk. I want you to reflect on that. How many people know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? You probably think that you know Him. You don't. Many of us don't really know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why we object at time of problems. That's why we doubt His justice. That's why we doubt Him answering our dua. How many people come to you, Sheikh? I was making dua for such a long time and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised He will answer me, but He didn't. Mashallah alaik, you were an angel. You lived like an angel and you're probably living like an angel now. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala failed His promise and you fulfilled your promise. A'udhu billah. Ma lakum la tarjuna lillahi waqara. Why you have no respect to observe and fulfill the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and then come and accuse Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You tell me you know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the first question is, who is your Lord? You and I know that we created to worship. Worship who? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How can you worship someone you don't really know? How can you love someone you don't really know? How can follow someone you don't really know? It's impossible. It's impossible to love or to fear something you don't know. So first question is, who's your Lord? Many of us focus in everything in our religion except knowing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's the first question you will be asked. So it's really how you lived your life. In Surah Al-Ankabut, the beginning of the surah says, أَحَسِبَ النَّاسُ أَن يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ. Do people think that they're going to say, لا إله إلا الله, I'm a believer, I'm a Muslim, without being tested? أعوذ بالله. You will be tested to prove that what you're saying is correct. And if you live, if you are truly a believer and you lived by that, at the end of the surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَالَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا فِينَا لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُلَنَا. And those who strove in our cause or for our cause, يعني they lived based on or according to the rules, we will surely guide them and we will surely help them to answer these three questions. Take Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, Abu al-Anbiya. Do you think he said, I know the questions? What do you think he did to prepare for this question, Man Rabbuk? When he was saved from his people from the fire, and he said, إِنِّي ذَاهِبٌ إِلَىٰ رَبِّي سَيَهْدِينَ. I'm going for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, leaving the place where I can't worship Him to a place I can worship Him. I'm leaving Him to the Holy Land. I'm leaving them to Jerusalem and that area. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala relieve our brothers and sisters and bring Jerusalem back where it belongs to the believers, to Muslimin. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. When he went there and he was debating with his people, and they told him that idols are our God. He said, as for me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is my Lord. And let me tell you something about him. This is what you need to know. This is what I need to know. This is what all of us need to know. قال, الَّذِي خَلَقَنِي فَهُوَ يَهْدِينَ. The one who created me, he will guide me. وَالَّذِي هُوَ يُطْعِمُنِي وَيَسْقِينَ. The one who provides for me everything, food and drink and everything. وَإِذَا مَرِضْتُ فَهُوَ يَشْفِينَ. And when I get sick, it's not the doctor, it's not the medicine that cured me, it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who cures me. وَالَّذِي يُمِيتُنِي ثُمَّ يُحْيِينَ. And He is the one who gives me life and take that life from me. وَالَّذِي أَطْمَعُ أَن يَغْفِرَ لِي خَطِيئَتِي يَوْمَ الدِّينَ. He is the one who can forgive my sins and He is the one who will account me the day of judgment. That's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do you know Him this way? That's a question that you need to ask yourself and ask me. I ask myself too, and I work hard to know it, to learn his names and attributes and all of that. Take Prophet Musa alayhi salam, when he was met with someone who claims he's God. قَالَ فَمَنْ رَبُّكُمَا يَا مُوسَى. Oh Musa, who's your Lord, you and your brother Harun alayhi salam. قَالْ, pay attention. رَبُّنَا الَّذِي أَعْطَى كُلَّ شَيْءٍ خَلْقَهُ ثُمَّ هَدَى. It is He who created subhanahu wa ta'ala everything the way they are, the shape they are, and it is He who guided them how to live in this world and provide for them. They know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Man Rabbuk? This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we need to know. Me and you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like the Prophet. So brothers and sisters, man nabiyuk, second question. I'm going to give you a saying of Ibn Mas'ud, and you decide on the answer. يقول ابن مسعود رضي الله عنه, he met or passed by a companion, his name الربيع بن خيثم رضي الله عنه. He was a youngster. He was busy with worship. He was worshiping. And that's not very common to see someone, a teenager, worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and busy with that. That's why they are so special in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they would be in his shade. So he said he passed by him, worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look what he told him. Look how you enjoin good and forbid evil with intelligence, indirect. You don't come to a person sometimes, maybe if you declare it easily, it would not get the fruit. Look what he told him. And look how beautiful that saying is. I reflected so much on it. He said, Ya Rabbi. Instead of coming to tell him, MashaAllah alaik, you are worshiping, great job, MashaAllah, continue. No, look what he said. Ya Rabbi. لو رآك رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لأحبك. He said, O Rabbi, if Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam saw what you're doing, he would love you. Didn't Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, if you follow Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Allah would love you? And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves you, go to Jannah. And I ask you a question. You and I, definitely going to meet Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam at his pool at the Hawd. And you will be resurrected the same thing, same way you die. The way you look, you think Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if he sees you, he would love you? This is off the topic. I want you to reflect on that. How does Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam look? How did he live his life, his appearance, how he looked, feature-wise, dress-wise, any of those things that you and I know that we have a sunnah in? Like for instance, when we dress our clothes, does it reflect arrogance? Dragging on the floor? Clothes that celebrities wear? Does it reflect sunnah? Is it too tight for men and women? Half hijab? No hijab? How does your face look? Does it look like Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Are you fulfilling what he commanded? How does your hair look? Do you resemble disbelievers? Do you do the things that he told you not to do, like qazr, shaving half of the head and leaving half? Answers you can only answer, not me. This is not a place where to say, is this haram or is this halal? I'm saying, will he love the way you look? Or will he turn his head away from you like he did to the two guys who came and he said, who commanded you to look like this? And they said, our Lord, their leader. He said, as for my Lord, he commanded me to have a beard. Yeah, I mean, I want to see the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I want to look the way he looks. I want to resemble him, not someone else. I want him to be happy when he sees me. And when someone comes and asks me, is this halal, is this haram? I don't tell him halal or haram. I tell him, would that please him when he looks at you? Is he going to say, mashallah, mashallah? Or he's going to turn his head away from you? Answer it. You do it yourself, brothers. The way you live on la ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah until you die. And To be affirmed in the hereafter is to know the answer for these questions. Wallah, if you did not live your life based on that, you would never answer it. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. Death summarized in three questions is our khutbah. من ربك ما دينك من نبيك. Who's your Lord, who's your Prophet, and what's your religion? If you live your life knowing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, remembering Him, thanking Him, worshipping Him, you answer the first question. Who's your Prophet? If you live your life following the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, looking like him, loving him, calling people to his Sunnah, holding in high regard his Sunnah, not shy of his Sunnah, you answer the second question. ما دينك, what's your religion? If you lived your life like a Muslim, knowing that the success of this world is based on Islam and the hereafter is Islam. فلا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. This is the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't you get to death, or don't let the angel of death catch you while you are not in the state of Islam, meaning while you are not in the state of adherence, meaning that is when you are not living according to Islam, don't you dare get caught like that. Live your life day and night, anywhere you go, according to Islam, and you will die on Islam. Do you call for Islam? You proud of Islam as a Muslim? Do you know what Islam means? Really, do you know what Islam means? Full, total submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Are you like that? Then you will get to answer, inshallah, that question easily. And look what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the Hadith Qudsi. إِنَّمَا هِيَ أَعْمَالُكُمْ أُحْصِيهَا لَكُمْ. It's your actions, I, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I'm keeping track of. فَمَنْ وَجَدَ خَيْرًا, you find something good, say alhamdulillah. فَلْيَحْمَدِ اللَّهِ. وَمَنْ وَجَدَ غَيْرَ ذَلِكَ, and if you find something different, bad deeds, فَلَا يَلُومَنَّ إِلَّا نَفْسُ, only you, blame yourself. وَمَا ظَلَمْنَاهُمْ وَلَكِنْ كَانُوا هُمُ الظَّالِمِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't transgress or commit dhulm against anyone, brother. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives all. So brothers and sisters, if you want to be affirmed on la ilaha illallah in this world, live that life. And if you want to be able to answer these three questions, then ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to affirm your heart. He is the one who said, يُثَبِّتُ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِالْقَوْلِ الثَّابِتِ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ. He is the one who affirms your heart, and he is the one who will make you say the answers if you live by him. And finally, brothers and sisters, I want you to be from those people who would fulfill this ayah. يَا أَيَّتُهَا النَّفْسُ الْمُطْمَئِنَّةِ ارْجِعِي إِلَىٰ رَبِّكِ رَاضِيَةً مَرْضِيَّةً فَدُخُلِي فِي عِبَادِي وَدُخُلِي جَنَّتِي. I want you, when the angel of death comes to you, he will call on to your soul. Oh, soul that is so content with la ilaha illallah, with tawheed. Come to your Lord who is so pleased to see you and to have you. Enter the group of the servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Enter the Jannah, inshallah. I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all from the people of the Jannah. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن ينفعنا بما سمعنا وأن يعلمنا ما ينفعنا وأن يجعلنا هداة مهتدين. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين وارفع بفضلك كلمتي الحق والدين. اللهم انصر إخواننا في فلسطين. اللهم كن معهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم عليك بأعدائك أعداء الدين، خذهم أخذ عزيز مقتدر، زلزل الأرض تحت أقدامهم. اللهم انصرنا عليهم يا رب العالمين. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك، أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت، استغفرك وأتوب إليك، وأقم الصلاة.
استقيموا يرحمني يرحمكم الله، سووا صفوفكم إن تسوية الصف من تمام الصلاة. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
آمين.
لله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض، وإن تبدوا ما في أنفسكم أو تخفوه يحاسبكم به الله، فيغفر لمن يشاء ويعذب من يشاء، والله على كل شيء قدير. آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون، كل آمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله لا نفرق بين أحد من رسله، وقالوا سمعنا وأطعنا، غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
آمين.
لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها، لها ما كسبت وعليها ما
اكتسبت. ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا. ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا. ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به. واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا. واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا. أنت مولانا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمدا. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.